How to calculate IRR, the internal rate of return, in Excel. And once you've calculated it, how to interpret IRR. We're going to use the same spreadsheet that we've used in the NPV in Excel video. So 1,000 of cash outflow right now in year 0, and then 4 years of 400 of benefits in the next 4 years. For NPV calculations, we used a discount rate of 20% and got to a net present value of 35. Now, internal rate of return is a related metric where you try to figure out the discount rate at which NPV would become zero. And the best way to do that is to insert the IRR formula in Excel through the search box. And you need to select the values that you want to take into account. So these are the nominal amounts of the project cash outflows and project cash inflows. Simply hit enter, and you get to an internal rate of return of 22%. Now for NPV, the rule is that any net present value bigger than zero creates value for the company, so should be accepted. For IRR, the rule is compare the IRR to the discount rate or weighted average cost of capital, and if the IRR is 22% and the discount rate is 20%, then the project is marginally better. It generates marginally better returns than the weighted average cost of capital, so you should accept it. Let's play around with this a little bit more. Let's assume that the benefits in the outer years go up to 600. The net present value becomes 248. To a lot of people, that's an abstract concept. The internal rate of return, if the benefits go up, the internal rate of return goes up. If you compare the weighted average cost of capital of 20% to the internal rate of return of 32%, that feels like it's a significant premium. It's a significant improvement versus the weighted average cost of capital. So for a lot of people, this is more intuitive. There are, however, some shortcomings or limitations of IRR. If you don't have an upfront investment, so if I delete this 1,000 over here, I still get the net present value, because that is simply the present value of the future cash flows over here. However, IRR does need an upfront investment in order to be able to calculate it. Thank you for watching. On my Finance Storyteller channel, I have several other videos on topics like NPV, IRR, and payback period. Please check them out.